Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Perkenalkan, nama saya Agia Anggraini. Saya dari kelas 1C Farmasi. Baiklah, di sini saya akan membacakan satu bab dari sebuah novel. Bab 6, yaitu The Smell of Old Horse. His name was River and he smelled like an old horse. Do you know how old horse smell like? The kind of smell that we simply can't pay no attention to. The smell that hit you the first time you walk into an old house that has been closed off for a while. Sometimes that smell lingers even after you have aired the flesh out. If you think about it, you will remember that unique smell, a little moldy, dusty, and strange, but somehow the air seems familiar. I've been thinking about him many times since we met. He was the one who saved me. Before him, life was different. It's been difficult to me. I was living in a bizarre world that I made of myself. And then he came into my life all of a sudden and it felt like glow. On the day we first met, I told him about his smell and I followed him everywhere. He asked me if it bothered me, and I said no, I like it. We became inspired since that day. He was like a character to me, watching every step I made. Like when I went out with a man didn't like, he won't stop troubling about him, and he walked by me cake when I was done. I remember on my birthday, he surprised me at night and booked me candle in a safe of cats. I have always enjoyed being with him. He led a nice and brilliant life. Sometimes I would watch him when we was eating, even when he didn't talk. Everything fascinates me. Even his plow, awkwardness, difficultness, he never liked to admit it, but he protects me. He can't say it, but I know he will never let harm to me. Since he was around, I can like myself and little better. I learned to accept myself and the world around me as it is. It wasn't only the way they treat me or the day we spent together, and I remember him everywhere. That scent of him was lingering in everything around me. I smelled his scent in my clothes, in the air, in his car, and everywhere. It felt like my life had been overwhelmed by that unique scent of him. But what reminded me the most of him was the book he gave to me, an old paperback that small trotting bird and old horse. It was his favorite novel. I found in his car and he said I could have it. So I kept it, and whenever I feel sad, I sniff it. He was always there when I need him. He didn't know that I had feeling for him. He only know that he was someone that I could always depend on, and he could see me in my ugly face when I was too lazy to take a bath. But he would always come and tell me that I looked so ugly when I cried that he wanted to fall. I liked he was always succeed to make me laugh again. He always found a way to, and we always went to the Arcade Arena, playing game that I would always lose. He never let me win. After that, I had to treat him cinnamon roll as a punishment. It was his favorite food. I found comfort in him. I am too afraid everything will change if River know that I love him. I know things will get awkward the moment I confessed, and I didn't want that. I feel a weight sensation, sort of burning kind of feeling, when I heard River talking about his cars. Obviously, I was lost interest, but he won't care and talking about here patiently. I don't think I will ever be ready if River with someone else. I know she will separate us sometime. I wish that he would never get a girlfriend and always be River that I know. That was the selfish part of me, but I kept this feeling for myself and never let him know. Because what I had was enough to make me happy, and that was what important. Although I know things would last forever and I would lose him sooner or later. It was on the afternoon and the air fired with the skin of duskiness. The sun was making a friendly touch with the clouds, a pleasant flash for the birds to fly around. The trees were swinging around like they were dancing to an old song. I feel welcome. I finally reached his place. I looked at his door. There was tension to it, but I finally knocking, and he opened the door, creaked away. I smile. Hey, come on in. When I say his face, I feel like I was finally finding a place that I could rest in. There was warmth and comfort to it, and my head finally fill it with some indescribable feelings. I'm knowing that the end will soon come. His place was clean and almost empty. There were boxes everywhere. Send them. I feel somber. I'm glad you came. I'm glad you came, he said while pouring water for me. The afternoon breeze blew in through an open window, and there came the sound of birds chirping. It was the day we had been waiting for. We were planning to go on a short trip. We haven't decided where we wanted to go, but for all I know, it will be the last trip we were going to have. The feeling of excitement and sorrow overwhelmed me, like the light the coming for the windows. It dazzled me. I take you anywhere you went, he said. We didn't talk much. We both know that we were exhausted. Tomorrow we'll go our separate way, I said. Let tomorrow be tomorrow and tonight. We will spend it together and let's just focus on that. He smiled for the first time since I felt. How about going to the beach? Sound good. I feel better and heavier. We got in the car and headed towards the beach. I look around to the road, pinky, building, son of the age. It was all suddenly felt important to me. It was night when we arrived on the beach, and there was a big round moon shining so bright. Look it contrast to the black sky. It was starless night, like it was time for the moon and nothing else. Its shadow was reflect on the ocean, displaying a beautiful scene before my eyes. It's been a long time since we went to the beach, I said to him, walking up some memories within us. We sat on the sand. The texture touched us, leaving marks on our skin. That night, the moon shining so brightly that I feel like it was shining specially for us, like we were the star of the world. By the spotlight on a big broad stage, I watched the waves and enjoyed the sensation of the ocean breeze swept across my face. The ocean was so fast, I felt like it come at us anytime. The few day we haven't talked much. We were trapped in the melancholy of our talks that we didn't have time to rest. But somehow that night we feel relaxed. The air around us had cooling down. Even on our way, I could sense the desperate within him. The situation hurt us more than anything, but there was nothing we could do. The image of him slowly disappeared came into me. Baiklah, itu saja novel yang dapat saya bacakan. Apabila ada kesalahan dalam penyebutan kata-kata, saya mohon maaf. Wabillahi taufiq walhidayah. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.